How's the day going so far?
Good.
What were you guys doing before this?
Always having drinks.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Champagne. As you do it, you're gone.
See all the experiences.
What brings you guys all back together?
I guess we saw the fan base that cares about the show. I'm really grateful to the audience and the guys. It's meant to do this and comedy with us. You know, give us some back to the fans. See that the show is still really relevant. People care and still talking about it. And all this world is a lot of passionate fans. It's weird because we had a very strong fantastic piece of work. I'm very grateful. I'm also very proud. It's almost like a parent. That was part of that. Yeah, it was a fantastic experience, and I'm honored that it's still relevant to me. It's many years ago.
What do you find to be the most relevant message for today's audience?
Well, in humanity, there's a long history of tolerance and miscommunication. If that show did anything, it caused that, forced people to have really honest discourse about looking at both sides of the story. I think we really lack that in Western culture, unfortunately. Because of media, because news sensationalized violence oftentimes, we're really missing the real stories. We're missing an empathetic attitude towards different cultures of the world that we know little about. It's very easy to be ethnocentric about them, to dehumanize different cultures, because we know nothing about them. All we do is the sensationalized violence that's associated with a certain culture. Whereas we're completely invalidating and disregarding the thousands of years of music, culture, art, and history. It's so easy to do that in this day and world, and we need that more than anything. It has to be empathy. That's what people really press that upon. It's got to be empathy. It has to be discourse. I truly believe it's human beings, the dialogue, the intelligence that is. And we can reach intelligent empathy and mutual compromise.
Do you think you would play your character any differently considering the current world that we live in now versus when you first started to play him when the series began?
I mean, as an older man, it's been years. The characters, I've been doing this professionally about 15, 16 years. And I read the first scene that I was going to audition for, and I didn't see the script. I knew who the healer was, 100%. I just finished it. Cerebral level, spiritual level, I just got it. You have to think about it. It's like, I read the sides and I was like, just get me in that room. Get me in that room. I'm going to do my job. And I was okay with not getting the gig or not. I kind of knew I was going to get it. It's happened only maybe twice in my career. It's a very rare thing. I just understood it. So I don't think it's going to be different.
Is there, during the shooting, as we started learning about it, during the silent, was there any hope amongst the cast and yourself, like, I'd like to be one, or maybe campaign for it, or anything?
Yeah, no, there might be amongst the cast. I don't know if anybody's actually campaigning to be this. I definitely thought that could have been a possibility. Okay. Let's be honest, it would have made amazing sense. The fact that the human had a son and made a baby, it would have made complete sense if that was the big turn in season 3 or season 4. That hero was the lead of Cyrus. And even when we were going into the last season, I agree with that. I could have been 5, 100%. So, when it didn't, sure. And when it didn't turn out that way, I don't know. I was much happier. That was the beauty of the show. Again, two different cultures, two different people, two different races. Putting those intolerances behind them on the side, and understanding each other and coming together. It's ultimately what it's about. Thank you, guys.
I just have a question. So your career in science fiction has been very extensive. You've done a lot of different roles. What do you think is your favorite, and what can you tell us about how you created the character when you were embodying it?
Okay, we'll go back to the previous question. Without a doubt, Hilo has probably been a significant character that I've done here. That said, I've done a couple scenes that have been really fun. I'll give you an example. I did a web series. It's called Ripley. I played like a time-traveling wizard. I cannot tell you how much fun I had doing that.
Hi. How are you?
I cannot tell you how much fun I did. I did that with an actress who I went to acting school with. So, 17 years ago, she's a dear friend of mine. We finally got to work together. It was a blast. I'm dying to meet her. Straight up comedy. It was one of the best experiences I had. I just recently worked on Walter Carver. And I played a character called Gimme. That was a fantastic experience. But I can't say anything about it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.